So you've just got yourself a copy of the Startup Framework, or you're just interested in seeing what all the fuss is about. Well, I'm David East, and today I'm going to be helping you get started with the Startup Framework. So to access your copy of the Startup Framework, you need to be logged in to DesignModo, and then if you go to your account, you then go to your download section where you can click right here to download the Startup Framework. And you'll notice that Startup is pretty big. But don't worry, you're not going to be hosting all of this. A lot of this is image assets as well as PSDs. And once it's downloaded, you can open up the folder, and you'll see two folders within Startup Framework, one for designer and one for developer. We'll be going over the contents within the developer folder. Within the developer folder, you'll see a folder for common files. And common files is what it sounds like. It's all of the common assets that you're going to be using while using the Startup Framework. It has icon fonts and icon images and common JavaScript libraries such as jQuery and Modernizer. Below common files is Flat UI, and this is the same free Flat UI that we all know and love. And below Flat UI is the manual. Within the read folder, this is where we can check out all the how-tos within the Startup Framework. So if we go and click on index, we're now within the user guide of the Startup Framework. You'll get a little blurb thanking you about purchasing this, and then you'll have a button here that'll help you get started. You'll see a blurb about using the HTML5 doc type, and then we'll focus on getting started. Now, the following version is about getting set up with CSS rather than less. In the next video, we'll be going over getting started with less. So as you can see down here, we have a snippet of code, and this is all the assets that you're going to need to get started. You'll see that Twitter Bootstrap is used as well as Bootstrap Responsive. Then we have to reference Flat UI. We'll use some icon fonts as well as animations. And below is jQuery, Bootstrap, and other jQuery plugins that we're going to need for our effects and functionality. And the second step is to pick the styles that you want to use. So in this snippet, you'll see that they're referencing styles for a header, a content, blog, contacts, and other pieces of the Startup Framework as well. And the reason why we pick and choose these styles is because we can pick and choose different code blocks. And if you're wondering what a code block is, we'll go back to the folder structure to find that out. So backing out to the UI kit folder, you'll see all these folders for blog, contacts, content, crew, footer, header, price, and projects. And these are all different types of HTML blocks we can use. So let's first check out the header. And within header, you'll see a CSS folder, a less folder, and an index.html document. So we'll open up the index.html to check out some of these header blocks. So these are all the headers that you can use within the Startup Framework. And as you notice as I'm scrolling through, these are all in a block format. This right here is a block, and the one above is also another block. So if we opened up the HTML page, we could take the code from this block and paste it into a file of our own, and we would have our header already taken care of for us. But your page isn't just going to be comprised of a header. You're also going to want to have other sections, such as content, and perhaps even a footer. And if you look at that top bar up there, you'll see links for content, footer, project, price table, blog, crew, contact. All these things are common components used in applications. And you might notice that those top links map exactly to the folder structure we were looking through. We're now within the UIKit content folder, and we can see this within our local URL. Right here, we have UIKit content slash index2.html. And within here are all the content blocks that you can combine with the previous header that you may have chosen. And the same goes for the footer page. These are all the footers that we can then append to the bottom of our page. But there's more things that you probably want to use than just a header and a content and a footer. There's also more interactive things such as the project page. A lot of times you might be selling an app or some type of product, and there is a lot of creative showcases within this project page. One of my favorites is right here below, with this image hover over effect. You can imagine how easy it is to take your own images and your own ideas and place them into here. And an awesome feature of all of this is that it's all responsive. As we scroll down, we can see that the same image effect looks great on a phone. And if you're selling something, you're probably going to want to use a pricing table. And all these are easily customized as well. And to figure out more information about customizing these components, we'll go back to the Startup User Manual, and we'll click on this Overview tab. And you'll see below it that we have all of our components within the Startup Framework. So if we click on Header, you'll notice that it's similar to the UIKit pages that we were looking at. But there's a big difference. We have this question mark to the right, and you'll notice it's on every single block. So if we come hover over one question mark, you can see that we get a little overlay and a little box pops up saying how to use this block. If we click again, we get a little push out. And this push out gives you steps on how you can set up this component within the Startup Framework. You get a little overview about this block and how it's designed to be used. It'll guide you to the installation page if you haven't set up Startup already. And then the next two steps depend on the version that you're going to be using. If you're just going to be using the CSS version, then you're going to take this markup right here, and you're just going to use that with a CSS file. If you're using Less, then we're going to have to import that specific Less document, but we'll get into that later. So above here, this is the actual markup that makes this header 2 block. So we could simply just copy this all the way to the bottom, and we could paste that into our application, and as long as we've already gone through that setup process, this will work perfectly. But we're interested in how we're going to customize this, so let's continue to scroll down, and we can see that the fifth step is component modification. So the component modification step shows us how we can change the background of this header block. And this header block has a blue background, and odds are that you're probably going to want to change that. And reading through this step, we can see that we just need to change the background style to the image that we want the background to be. And we also can apply some opacity to that background if we wish. And if we keep scrolling down, we can see there's more information if you're using the Less version. If you're familiar with Less, you'll know that there's an opacity function that provides cross-browser compatibility for the opacity function. And also, if we want to replace the content within this header block, we can read through this little step right here, and it'll explain to us how to do so. So the main scaffolding behind this header block is a hero unit. So all we have to do is look inside the tags for the hero unit, and then we can change anything how we wish. And the next step is the samples. And this shows what samples this header block is used in. In this case, we can see that it was used in sample 2. So if I right click and open this in a new tab, we can see this header used in a sample. And Startup comes with several samples that'll help you understand how these blocks are used together and give you any inspiration for your ideas. So we'll go back to our folder structure and take a look at the samples. So back in the folder structure, we're going to want to take a look at the samples folder. And as you can see, there are 25 samples for us to look at. So let's scroll back up and start with the first one. And we'll just click on the index.html document to open it up. And here in our first sample, we can see that we have a header block right here. And that allows us to toggle through and see different headlines and images. And as we scroll down, we get some fade-in effects, and the header actually shrinks and docks to the top of our page. So we have a content page. And as you can see, some animation for the second part of our content. And then we also have a footer. And there are 24 other sample pages that'll help inspire you and also help quickly build out your idea. So seeing all this code is great, but if you're a designer, you probably want to see the mockups that created this page. So if we go back to our folder structure, we can scroll all the way back to the designer folder. And within here, you'll see assets, images, samples, and UIKit. If we go to samples and go to the first sample, we can open up the same sample that we went through as HTML. And now you can see we have this loaded up. If we zoom in a little bit, we can see that it looks like the same piece of HTML that we went through. And down here, we have all of our folders for all of our layers. And one thing to take note of is the numbers within the folders. That's header number 1, content number 4, content 25, and footer number 6. And the significance of these numbers is that is the number of the block that is being used from the Startup Framework. So going through these folders, we can see which blocks were used to create these styles. So instead of actually looking at samples, we can go and look at the UI kits themselves. So if we go back to our folder, and we'll get out of samples, and we'll go into UI kit, and we'll go into header, and we'll open up the PSD for header. We'll keep the layers, and we will update. And now zoomed in a bit, we see that these are all the headers. And to the right in the layers, we see header number 1, 2, 3, and all the way down to header number 23. So you have 23 headers to pick from and to customize. Because within each header, we can change out the logo, we can mess around with any of the text, we can even change out the arrows that you click on to see the different slides. And one of the great things about this is you can actually drag this folder into a blank PSD and you can use that as a header. And then we can go into the content folder and we can open up content 1 PSD. And within content1.psd, we can see all the content blocks within their folders. So we could drag one of these content blocks and we could put that below a header block. So you can see that it's very easy to stack these blocks in order to make a design. And then from there, it's very easy to customize that design as well. So in the next tutorial, we'll create a design by stacking multiple blocks from the startup framework. We'll do some customization as well, and then you'll see just how powerful the startup framework really is.